In this illustration, we are going to analyze what happens if there exists a variation of dielectric in a capacitor along the plates. Here in this illustration, we are given that in a parallel plate capacitor of plate area A, which is L by B and a separation is D. If a dielectric is filled, of which the dielectric constant varies linearly from one end of plate to the other as epsilon r is equals to mx plus n, where x is the distance from one end of the plate along the length, we are required to determine the capacitance of this capacitor. Such a concept we call calculation of capacitance by using variation of parameters. Let's draw the capacitor. So, if these are the two plates of capacitor which are of length L, and I'm assuming their width is B, and say the terminals of the two plates are X and Y, and the separation between the plates is given as D. And here within the region between the plates, the dielectric constant is varying according to this law. So here, as this dielectric is varying in its dielectric constant, I consider an elemental section in this dielectric, which is of width dx, which you can see I am taking here. And this elemental section I can consider is of capacitance dc, of which these two are the upper and lower plates. So here we calculate capacitance of elemental section as shown is, this can be written as dc, and for these two plates their width is b and length here I am taking as dx, so its capacitance will be given as epsilon naught epsilon r, area of the plates is b dx divided by d. And the value of epsilon r within this element dx can be given by this relation. So here the value of dc is this, and between the values of x from 0 to L, you can see all such dc's, upper and lower plates are connected to each other. So all such dc's can be considered to be in parallel. So we can write here all dc's are in parallel. So we can use C equivalent across terminals x and y as dc1 plus dc2 and so on, which can be written as integration of dc. So here it is epsilon naught b by d is a constant for dc, and this epsilon r we can integrate from 0 to L, that is mx plus n and dx. So on substituting we are getting epsilon naught b by d, you know, integrating we are getting mx square by 2 plus nx, limits from 0 to L, and on substituting the values we are getting epsilon naught b by d ml square by 2 plus nl. That will be the answer to this problem.